science of color, the whole science of mixing colors, mm-hmm. the mystery of the color gray, for instance. You mm-hmm. get into a two-hour program just about gray, the color gray, and mm-hmm. how significant that is. Mm-hmm. You know, and you can go into the whole thing about the Kabbalah with this, you know,
yeah.
color, whole thing, the whole yeah. thing with color. But the mixing of color, the ritual of letting the colors teach you, mm-hmm. do you have a relationship with color? Nobody has a relationship with color. No. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, on and on and on. Once mm-hmm. you start becoming awakened into the whole, what the inanimate world can teach you, architecture.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for me, just looking at the architecture, the buildings, mm-hmm. is an incredible enlightening experience.
Yeah.
You know, and how light plays on certain kinds of buildings and the whole inanimate thing. I've always been into that. The beauty of a guitar or a piano.
Mm-hmm.
The beauty of a wood, you know, on mm-hmm. a beautiful table, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, this can involve the creations of men, obviously.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because, of course, the men who've created things based on their discovery and their learning from nature is mm-hmm. perfectly acceptable.
Yeah.
Mm. But a man who's a demented, tortured, you know, mentally amputated, mutilated shard trying to build stuff in his antithesis, in his antipathy to nature, that's mm. obscene. And mm. that's what we're getting more and more of in our world,
mm.
is nature being pushed back, you know, from our dialogue.
Mm.
And this manufacture of this hideous, monstrous, anti-human type of world.
Mm.
We have to really come back into it. And I really believe it. That's why a lot of the gods were portrayed in ancient times with animal form.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the reasons. Mm. It's because of what the animals can teach us. And what the so-called inanimate that we've been trained to believe is below us or lower than us.
Mm.
See, I don't believe that the dolphins and the whales are lower forms than us. I believe they're higher forms of life, actually.
Mm.
I absolutely believe that.
Mm.
I absolutely believe that wolves... You know, and I mean, people can laugh their heads off if they feel like it, but, you know, there was a reason why the Nagas, the ancient gods, were portrayed as serpents.
Mm.
See? I got questions about this, and I've been looking into some of this stuff, and why certain animals were sacred. You know, you had an interview with Andrew Collins in which he was talking at length about the vulture, you know, and how important that was. Later, that morphed into the dove.
The Cygnus,
you know, and the swan,
yeah.
See, obviously Christianized a little bit, but the utter significance that some of these animals had. The horse, look how significant the horse was to the Scythians and the Celts.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, these guys had the horses in their houses.
Mm.
Look at the you know, the Lord of the Rings, the story of the Rohan, the people of the riders of Rohan,
yeah,
right, and the relationships with their horse,
right, yeah.
connecting to Epona and the goddess, you know, of the horse, and that the horse was not some blinking beast of burden to these people.
Yeah.
It was their gods, sacred, man. This was sacred.
Yeah, yeah.
What the hell, you know? The rat. You know, they have these beautiful temples to the rat over in India.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love that. You know, I'm not going to go and worship some god in some temple, but open a temple to the rat, and I'm all for it. You know, and they literally do that. They have these rat temples which they feed the rats, and that, to me, that's absolutely what I'm talking about.
Nice.
The day of the rat will come, you know.
Very nice. Yeah, Michael, so round things up here. You know, we might have new listeners with us and people who don't know about your DVD series and so forth. Give us out the website for that and what you would recommend, again, in connection to this interview and so forth.
Well, the DVDs are on Origins and Oracles, because they're all one series. 6 DVDs, box sets, you know, and you can look at all of that, including the Atlantis book on originsandoracles.com. And if they go to michaeltessarian.com, that will get them to all the different websites I've got. I've got 6 or 7 websites. And certainly everyone's welcome to come on the new forum, which is the MSAR forum, M-T-S-A-R forum. It's at redicecreations.com / MSAR forum.
Yeah.
And come on there and leave their comments.
Mm.
And also the forum is for putting up posts. See, a lot of what I do is collaborative.
Mm.
I rely on people to send me, you know, clips,
material
yeah. Editorials, amazing things that they discover.
Mm.
And then the forum is where we post all of this stuff so people can see that, you know, it embellishes what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Because people are discovering a lot of things around the world. This is a time of awakening.
Yeah.
You know, the planet Pluto and the planet Uranus are operating to bring in a new spirit of rebellion, which is extremely important, and it's connected to the Holy Spirit, you know, the coming of the true Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And so there's a real awakening happening all around the world, and every day we're sent material saying, hey, you know, we found this in our local neighborhood, or this is going on, or look at the symbolism that I discovered.
Mm.
So I want people to really come by as much as they can to the forum and send us stuff, you know, and let's help open the eyes of the world.
Yeah. Definitely.
So the forum again is at redicecreations.com/ MSAR forum.
Yeah, and I linked up just previously here the web streams, all the web streams that Michael have up there. Tons of free stuff to look through. And then, you know, when you're ready, head on over to originsandoracles.com and support Michael and get one of those DVDs, because that's excellent information on there. So, again, Michael, thank you so much for coming on, and thank you for spending your time with us here. We
thank
so
you.
Much appreciate it.